On the phone with us, one of the best trainers in the history of boxing, Teofimo Lopez Jr. He's the father of Teofimo Lopez. It's very hard to make a champion, period. It's even harder to make a champion from scratch. Danny Garcia's dad did it. Emmanuel Stewart did it. You did it, of course. Joe Goosen did it with the Durellis brothers. Not everybody could do that, Junior. Not everybody could take someone that never threw a jab and make them a champion. How hard is it?
Listen, I always knew it from the beginning because when he was 13, going into 14, 15, he was already fighting, you know, sparring, you know, elite fighters, you know, guys that were going to fight world titles, or guys that were, you know, getting ready, you know, guys that were already world champions, and he was destroying them, you know, he was doing great. So I always knew that he was special. You know, one thing that I always tell every parent and every person out there, you know, that's starting a career for their kids or whatever it is, in this sport where you got to teach your kids, you know, you got to teach them to entertain the crowd. You know, you got to be an entertainer. This is not about going in there and winning fights. You know, a lot of people can win fights. It's hard to entertain the crowd. That's what's hard, you know. And I was very strict about that with my son. You know, I used to always tell him, listen, if you're gonna go in there, you gotta do your thing. You gotta look sharp, and you gotta look, you know, you gotta be likable. And bro, he started doing that from the moment he started boxing, you know, with his catch and shoot, you know. And I tell a lot of people that catch and shoot take years and years to learn. You can never stop teaching somebody, you know, how to, because you know what it is, Ellie? It's I don't know how to explain it, but I'll try to explain it the best I can. When you box, when you're in there and you're boxing, you gotta feel every punch the other puncher is throwing. Because as soon as you feel it, let's say somebody throws a body shot,
yeah,
a left body shot, and you feel it on your elbow, you know that person is open for a good shot. So then you come and you throw an uppercut or you throw a straight right hand. You know, shit like that makes you it makes you invisible. It makes you the best fighter in the world because it looks pretty. You know, especially with the Mike Galeno fight. I don't know if you caught that punch that he hit Mike Galeno with, where he catches it with his right hand. You know, I think it was his right hand. He catches it with his right hand, and he comes back with a flush uppercut. That was pretty. You know what I'm saying? That's what people want to see, something different. You don't want to see nobody taking – you don't want to see nobody – on their phones. You don't want to see nobody talking to a person next to them unless they're talking about the fight.
Getting up, going to get a drink, coming back, going to smoke, coming back, going to the bathroom three times.
You notice when my son fights, he's focused. He's like, he's watching you like a shark, you know what I'm saying? So that's what you teach your kids. When you're telling me how hard it is, it's very hard. Because one thing you have to understand, you should never ever be You should never be able to stop being able to teach your fighter something new. You always got to be able to teach them something new. You can never stop from you teaching them how to learn, how to do something different, because then you're done as a coach.
Yeah,
so you know what? In this game, it's not easy. You know, especially when you got to bring up ideas every day and it makes you a better coach. You know, fight through fights. That's why I always choose the hardest, you know, what you call it, fights, because we want to learn.
I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Sekback, reporting.